So hi everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to another session of PIB 247. In today's class, we will be talking about PIB news from 14th to 15th of February 2023. And yes, the RBI notification कभी भी आ सकता है, as we all know कि मतलब ऐसा बोला जा रहा है कि अप्रैल के फर्स्ट वीक में फेज वन हो जाएगा, और अगर ऐसा सच है तो definitely the notification will come in this month. Otherwise also अप्रैल में हो या ना हो, वी ऑल नो दैट नोटिफिकेशन विल डेफिनेटली कम. सो लेट अस नॉट वेट फॉर द नोटिफिकेशन एंड लेट्स स्टार्ट प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर दिस एग्जाम फ्रॉम टुडे इटसेल्फ. तो अगर आप में से कई लोग अभी नोटिफिकेशन का वेट कर रहे हैं, सो प्लीज डोंट डू दैट, जस्ट स्टार्ट योर प्रिपरेशन. ओके, सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द क्लास गाइज एंड लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, विच इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन आई वुड से. मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हेल्थ एंड फैमिली वेलफेयर हेडेड बाय मनसुख मंडाविया हैज रिसेंटली लॉन्च्ड नेशन वाइड सर्व दवा सेवन. सर्व दवा सेवन, दवा इज मेडिसिन, और इन इंग्लिश वी कैन से मास ड्रग एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन कैंपेन टू एलिमिनेट विच डिजीज. सो फॉर विच डिजीज दिस मास ड्रग एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन कैंपेन हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड बाय द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हेल्थ एंड फैमिली वेलफेयर, दैट इज द क्वेश्चन. सो रिमेंबर दिस मास सर्व दवा सेवन और मास ड्रग एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन कैंपेन हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड टू एलिमिनेट लिम्फैटिक फिलेरिसिस. Right, which disease we are talking about? We are talking about lymphatic filariasis. Right, now remember, this disease is a vector-borne disease which is caused by Culex mosquito. Right, Culex mosquito, and India has set a target to eliminate this disease by the year 2027, which is 3 years ahead of the global target. Right, so that is why this Mass Drug Administration campaign has been launched. And the objective, of course, is to end lymphatic filariasis transmission through the door-to-door, right? Door-to-door administration of antifilarial drugs. So, how this door-to-door antifilarial drugs ka transmission will take place? So, basically, what will happen? Jo health workers honge, health workers will go door-to-door and they will distribute the antifilarial drugs to eliminate this particular disease from the society. All right, and this campaign will be conducted in 10 most affected states of the nation, which are Bihar, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, Maharashtra, Uttar Pradesh, West Bengal, Karnataka, Odisha, Madhya Pradesh and Andhra Pradesh. So these are the 10 most affected states of due to lymphatic filariasis, and in these states only this mass drug administration campaign will be conducted. All right, and what will happen under this? As I told you, the door-to-door distribution of antifilarial drugs will take place, and this will be done by the help of health workers. Okay, so that is all about this news. And which disease is this? It is lymphatic filariasis. Option A is the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 2. What was the theme of the third edition of ASEAN India Digital Ministers meeting, which was held recently on a virtual platform? So this was a virtual meeting between ASEAN and India, and it was the third edition of ASEAN India Digital Ministers meeting, right? So the very basic question has been asked here: what is the theme? What was the theme of this meeting? So let's talk about it. Remember, this was the third edition of ASEAN India Digital Ministers meeting, and the objective was basically to discuss how we can strengthen the relationship in the area of ICT, information and communication technology, between India and ASEAN countries. All right, that was the objective of this meeting, and the theme was synergy towards a sustainable digital future. Synergy towards a sustainable digital future was the theme of this meeting. Okay, now remember, during the meeting, India ASEAN Digital Work Plan 2023 was launched under, and this work plan, basically what is this work plan? Under this work plan, there are certain steps that will be taken in the ASEAN nations and the India to strengthen the ties between ASEAN nations and India. And ये tie जो है strengthen इसलिए किया जाएगा ताकि दोनों ही organizations में, मतलब ASEAN में और India में, दोनों में जो ICT infrastructure है या जो digital ecosystem है उसको और ज्यादा मजबूत किया जा सके. Alright, and this work plan consists of these themes like artificial intelligence in cyber security, application of internet of things and AI, sustainable data and transport network for future, 5G technologies for IoT and future trends, and role of ICT in implementation of digital health. Now you don't have to remember all these themes, that are not required. Just remember that during the meeting, India ASEAN Digital Work Plan 2023 has been launched. which will provide a platform, which will provide, you know, which will provide कि कैसे हमें आगे डिजिटल इकोसिस्टम को मजबूत करना है आसियान नेशन में और इंडिया में, राइट? सो दैट इज ऑल अबाउट दिस मीटिंग एंड व्हाट वाज़ द थीम. इट वाज़ सिनर्जी टुवर्ड्स अ सस्टेनेबल डिजिटल फ्यूचर. ऑप्शन बी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. मूविंग अहेड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 3. विच ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, दिस इज अगेन अ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन, विच ऑर्गेनाइजेशन वॉज अनाउंस्ड बाई इंडिया ड्यूरिंग इंडिया एनर्जी वीक 2023. सो एज यू ऑल नो, last week we have observed India Energy Week 2023, right? So a new organization has been announced by India, which will facilitate and intensify the use of sustainable biofuels, including in the transportation sector. That is a new organization that has been announced by India. ठीक है? So you have to just the name, which organization is this? और जब इसके बारे में और details आएगी, तो we will discuss those details as well. ठीक है? So this new organization has been announced, which is named as Global Biofuel Alliance. Global Biofuel Alliance is the new organization that has been announced by India. And along with India, there are two more nations, which are Brazil and United States. So Brazil, India and United States will collaborate with each other to form this organization, Global Biofuel Alliance. And as the name says, a Global Biofuel Alliance, which means all these countries, the three countries, will work towards strengthening the biofuel ecosystem or in these three countries. और इसके अलावा अगर और कोई interested nation आना चाहेगा तो that country, that nation can also join this network, this alliance, right? The objective is to facilitate cooperation and intensify the use of sustainable biofuels, thereby eliminating the use of fossil fuels, energy generated from the fossil fuels. ठीक है? Launch year 2023, इसी साल launch हुआ है. And remember, these are the four areas on which this Global Biofuel Alliance will give emphasis. Number one, it will strengthen the market of biofuels so that the biofuels can be easily available for the consumers. Number two, facilitate global biofuels trade. क्योंकि अगर कोई country biofuel बनाने में सक्षम नहीं है, if any country is not able to produce the biofuels, then it can import from other nation which has strong ability to produce the biofuels. ठीक है? Develop concrete policy, lesson sharing, and finally provide technical support for national biofuel programs worldwide. पूरी दुनिया में national biofuel programs के through technical support ये Global Biofuel Alliance provide कराएगा. Okay? So that is all till now about this organization, and once the more details are out, we will discuss about those details as well. So which organization is this? It is Global Biofuels Alliance. Option B again is the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 4. Which ministry has organized the first international conference on digital skilling recently in New Delhi to foster collaboration and knowledge sharing in the field of digital skilling and develop strategies for upskilling and reskilling workers globally? So as the name says, it was the international conference on digital skilling, which means the discussions were there regarding how we can provide skills to the youth, to the laborers, to the other people who wants to have it, right? So it was organized by Ministry of Electronics and IT in New Delhi, and the objective, as the question already has mentioned, was to foster collaboration and knowledge sharing in the field of digital skilling, and how we can give or how we can provide best skills to the youth of the nation. ठीक है? Organizer, National Institute of Electronics and Information Technology, which works under the Ministry of Electronics and Technology. And basically this conference was held under this initiative of National Institute of Electronics and IT, which is NICE-DT. NICE-DT stands for National Institute of Electronics and Information Technologies, International Conference on Communication, Electronics and Digital Technologies. So you should remember the short form only. NICE-DT was the name of the initiative under which this International Conference on Digital Skilling took place. ठीक है जी? So that is all about this also, and the correct answer is option B again, Ministry of Electronics and IT. Moving ahead to question number 5. Very straightforward question. Where was G20 Empower inception meeting under India's G20 presidency held? Now guys, G20 ki bahut sari meetings ho rahi hai, and all the meetings are important, the locations at least, because one or two questions you are definitely you know you will definitely get during your in your examination. ठीक है, that is for sure. So that is why all the meetings of G20 under India's presidency are important. So this is new meeting G20 Empower Inception meeting. Where did it take place? That is the question. So remember, it took place in Agra. And where is Agra? Agra, of course, we all know is in Uttar Pradesh. The nodal organizing ministry was the Ministry of Women and Child Development, right? Women and Child Development. Now the nodal ministry is the Ministry of Women and Child Development, which means there was something regarding women or child, right? And Empower naam se bhi clear hai that it must be about women, right? So the Ministry of Women and Child Development was the nodal organizing ministry, and this ministry is headed by Smriti Irani. ठीक है, and the theme was empowering women to lead across sectors, role of digital skilling and future skills. So as I told you, when we see the word empower and when we see the ministry as the Ministry of Women and Child Development, which means this meeting was specially meant for women. ठीक है, now these were the three focus areas of this meeting. Number one, women's entrepreneurship. Number one, partnership for promoting women's leadership. Number three, education, which is the key to women's empowerment, right? So these were the key focus areas. Number one, women entrepreneurship, partnership for promoting women's leadership, and education of women. Theek hai ji? So that is all about it. And where did it take place? It took place in Agra. Option E is the correct answer. Let's move ahead to question number six then. Dhara. This is about Dhara. Dhara stands for Driving Holistic Action for Urban Rivers. Driving Holistic Action for Urban Rivers, the 2023, the annual meeting of the members of River City Alliance. So there is a River Cities Alliance where there are 95 members from the river cities. ठीक है, and all these 95 member cities meet. This meeting took place to discuss how we can manage the urban rivers. Right, the River Cities Alliance was formed with this objective only, on how we can manage the urban rivers. ठीक है, so Dhara 2023, the annual meeting of members of River Cities Alliance will be held in Pune. So you have to identify incorrect statement about River Cities Alliance. So let's talk about the news and then we will come back to the question. So as I told you, this meeting will take place in Pune in Maharashtra, and objective of course will be to provide a platform to all the members of the River Cities Alliance on then you basically the discussions will take place on how we can improve the strategies to manage the urban rivers. ठीक है, to provide a platform for senior officials of the 95 member River Cities Alliance in India to co-learn and discuss solutions for managing local water bodies. So as I told you, that is the objective. It was organized by National Mission for Clean Ganga. It is very, very important, in collaboration with National Institute of Urban Affairs. Now remember, National Mission for Clean Ganga works under the Ministry of Jal Shakti, and National Institute of Urban Affairs works under the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. ठीक है, and River Cities Alliance also is the collaboration of these two ministries only. ठीक है, now remember, this Dhara was organized, will be organized for municipal commissioners. जितने भी municipal commissioners होंगे of the member cities, they will come and they will discuss on they will discuss that how they can manage efficiently the urban water bodies or the urban rivers. Now it will have a strong synergy with the Urban 20. See, there is an Urban 20 initiative under G20. Now, why it will have a strong synergy with Urban 20? Because under Urban 20, there is a subtopic of discussion, that is urban water security, right? Under U20, there is a there is a area of focus which is urban water security, and that is why it is in line with the Urban 20. Which Dhara? This Dhara meeting is in line with the Urban 20 because Urban 20 has urban water security as one of the thrust areas. ठीक है, moving ahead. Now these two sessions will take place in this meeting: session on technology and innovation, how we can make use of technology in managing the urban water bodies, and youth for rivers. In this session, the young people will be motivated, or young people will be invited with their ideas on how basically if they have any idea to manage, to efficiently manage the urban water bodies. Okay? Now talking about River Cities Alliance, so remember it was formed in the year 2021. The objective is same, बहुत बार बोल दिया मैंने, management of urban water bodies. It is the first of its kind alliance in this world, dedicated for river cities to ideate, discuss and exchange information for sustainable management of urban rivers. So management of urban rivers, बहुत बार मैं बता चुका हूँ, that is the basic objective of this. ठीक है, membership currently, initially when it was started there were 30 members. Currently it has 95 members and it is open for all the river cities of India. जितने भी river cities हैं वहां के जो भी municipal commissioner हैं, they can become the members or the entire city can become the member of River City Alliance. Ministry, as I already told you, it is Ministry of Jal Shakti and Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. It is a collaboration between these two ministries and the three broad areas where RCA work is the networking, the capacity building and the technical support. And all these things have a single major focus, that is the management of urban rivers. ठीक है, इन सभी चीजों का जो फोकस है वो एक ही है, मैनेजमेंट ऑफ अर्बन रिवर्स, दैट इज इट. ठीक है, ऑल राइट गाइस, सो दैट इज ऑल अबाउट दिस न्यूज एंड नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन एंड लेट्स आइडेंटिफाई इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट अबाउट आरसीए. इट इज फर्स्ट ऑफ इट्स काइंड अलायंस इन द वर्ल्ड डेडिकेटेड फॉर रिवर सिटीज टू आइडिएट डिस्कस एंड. ठीक है, ये तो एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट. इट इज एडवाइसेड एज अ फैसिलिटेटरी प्लेटफॉर्म फॉर इनिशिएटिंग रिवर सेंसिटिव प्लानिंग एंड डेवलपमेंट, ये भी ठीक है. It was launched in 2020. Is that so? No. It was launched in 2021, which makes this statement incorrect. Currently, it has 105 cities as members. 105 तो नहीं है. अभी हमने discuss करा, there are 95 members. And its three broad themes are networking, capacity building, and technical support. So the incorrect statements are 3 and 4, which means option B is the correct answer. Moving ahead guys to question number 6, which is again a very very important question. It is about the national literacy new India literacy program. Ministry of Education headed by Dharmendra Pradhan has started a new scheme of education for all, which is adult education ko inhone is scheme ke baad education for all bola tha, which is nothing but new India literacy program. ठीक है, इसको हमने पहले भी डिस्कस कर रखा है कई बार, बट जो लोगों ने नहीं पढ़ा है दोस गाइस कैन स्टडी. सो हैज स्टार्टेड अ न्यू स्कीम ऑफ एजुकेशन फॉर ऑल विद अ विजन टू सपोर्ट स्टेट्स और यूटीज इन प्रमोटिंग लिटरेसी अमंग नॉन लिटरेट्स इन द एज ग्रुप ऑफ व्हाट. ठीक है, सो इट इज नथिंग बट न्यू इंडिया लिटरेसी प्रोग्राम विच वॉज लॉन्च लास्ट ईयर 2022 एंड एज द नेम सेज न्यू इंडिया लिटरेसी प्रोग्राम द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस प्रोग्राम इज टू इराडिकेट इलिटरेसी फ्रॉम द कंट्री. ठीक है, जितने भी इलिटरेट लोग हैं उनको पढ़ाया जाएगा, उनको सिखाया जाएगा. ठीक है, इंप्लीमेंटेशन पीरियड विल बी फ्रॉम दिस फाइनेंशियल ईयर, दैट इज फ्रॉम फाइनेंशियल ईयर 23 टू फाइनेंशियल ईयर 2027. द स्कीम विल कवर नॉन लिटरेट ऑफ द एज ग्रुप ऑफ 15 ईयर्स एंड अबव, 15 साल से ऊपर के जितने भी लोग हैं, 15 साल या उससे ऊपर, 15 ईयर्स एंड अबव in all the states and UTs of the nation. All right, so the target is very important under this scheme. The target for foundation literacy and numeracy for financial year 22 financial year 23 to 27, this should be financial year 23, is 5 crore learners. Theek hai, total target is how much? 5 crore learners at the rate of 1 crore per year by using OTLAS. What is OTLAS? Online Training, Learning and Assessment System. Sorry. Online Training, Learning and Assessment System is OTLAS in collaboration with National Informatics Center, NCRT and National Institute of Open Schooling, which is NIOS. Alright. So remember, total number of learners that will be trained is 5 crores. And how many learners will be trained per year? 1 crore. ठीक है, total outlay is 1037.90 crore, out of which 700 crore will be provided by the central government and the rest amount will be borne by the state governments respectively. The scheme has these priorities: number 1, girls and women; number 2, SC, ST, OBC and minorities; number 3, person with special needs or you can say person with disabilities or divyangjans, and marginalized nomadic construction laborers or laborers who are generally unserved and underserved in the society. All right, talking more about it, so there are five components of it: foundational literacy and numeracy, where the government will teach, where the, you know, the stakeholders will teach the illiterate people about the foundational literacy and numeracy, basic reading, basic numbering, paise ginna, ye sari cheeze sikhai jayengi. Critical life skills will be taught, vocational skills development, basic education and continuing education, right? So these are the five components of New India Literacy Program, and it is implemented through volunteerism. Kisi ko sarkar pakad ke khich ke nahi layegi ki aao beta padho, aisa nahi hoga, volunteerism ke through chalega. The learners will be encouraged to access the content in the local languages and online mode through the very famous platform of the Ministry of Education, which is Diksha platform. All right, so that is all about this scheme. And what is the age group? 15 and above, option B is the correct answer. All right, so now let's move ahead to the questions in short, which do not need much explanation. But before that, if you want to have the PDF of this session, you can join this Telegram channel. The link is provided in the description. And if you want to ask anything related to examination, you can follow me here. Question number 7, which city will be hosting the first edition of Agriculture Deputies Meeting of Agriculture Working Group under India's G20 presidency? Again, a question on meeting under India's G20 presidency. Remember, this meeting will take place in the cleanest city of India, that is Indore. Option B is the correct answer. Question number 8, where was National Philatelic Exhibition MritPex 2023 organized by the Department of Post under the Ministry of Communication? So that is again a very straightforward question. This National Philatelic Exhibition took place in New Delhi. Option B is the correct answer. Question number 9, where has the 9th International Chefs Conference been organized by Indian Federation of Culinary Association, which was supported by Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare? This conference again took place in New Delhi. Option E is the correct answer. Question number 10, where has President Draupadi Murmu inaugurated the second edition of Indian Rice Congress, which was organized by Association of Rice Research Workers? So where it was organized? It was organized in Odisha. Where in Odisha? In Cuttack. Option C is the correct answer. Question number 11, this is something which is important and interesting. Spices Board of India under Ministry of Commerce and Industry has established 8 crop specific spices parks across the country. The question is, which of the following given pairs is are correctly matched? Kitne pairs? Kitne pairs? Not which. How many hona chahiye yahan pe? How many given pairs is are correctly matched? I will make this change in the PDF, don't worry. How many given pairs is are correctly matched? That is the question. Kitne pair correctly matched hai? ठीक है, तो ये पहले 8 जो स्पाइसेस पार्क है उनको देख लेते हैं. दीज आर दी 8 स्पाइसेस पार्क. दीज आर द नेम, और यू कैन से द प्लेस. दीज आर द स्टेट्स, और दीज आर द स्पाइसेस कवर्ड. इन छिंदवाड़ा इन मध्य प्रदेश, द स्पाइस कवर्ड इज गार्लिक एंड चिली. इन गुना, अगेन इन मध्य प्रदेश, इट इज कोरियंडर. इन गुंटूर आंध्र प्रदेश, चिलीज. जोधपुर राजस्थान, क्यूमिन. व्हाट इज दिस? रामगंज मंडी. यस, रामगंज मंडी इन राजस्थान, कोरिएंडर. पुट्टाडी इन केरला, कार्डमम इन पेपर. रायबरेली उत्तर प्रदेश, मिंट. एंड शिवगंगा इन तमिलनाडु, चिलीज एंड टर्मरिक. सो दीज आर दी 8 सिटीज, 8 स्पाइस पार्क, 8 स्टेट्स एंड दी नेम ऑफ द स्पाइसेस. ठीक है, सो नाउ यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई हाउ मेनी पेयर्स आर करेक्ट. छिंदवाड़ा मिंट, इज दैट करेक्ट? नो, आई थिंक छिंदवाड़ा में गार्लिक एंड चिली है. मिंट इज इन रायबरेली, आई बिलीव. ठीक है, लेट्स चेक इट. ठीक है, लेट्स नॉट गेट रॉन्ग. यस, छिंदवाड़ा गार्लिक एंड चिली, रायबरेली मिंट. सो दिस इज इनकरेक्ट. गुंटूर चिलीज इज करेक्ट. पुट्टाडी कार्डमम एंड पेपर इज करेक्ट. रायबरेली गार्लिक एंड चिली करेक्ट हो गया, बिकॉज ये यहां पे इन्होंने क्या करा, क्वेश्चन में एक्सचेंज कर दिया रायबरेली और छिंदवाड़ा का. सो ओनली 2 पेयर्स आर करेक्ट. ऑप्शन बी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. एंड गाइस, द लास्ट क्वेश्चन फॉर टुडे, the National Food Security Act of 2013, this is a very important question, provides for coverage of up to up to how much percent of the rural and up to how much percent of the urban population for receiving highly subsidized food grains under TPDS. And now every beneficiary, all the beneficiaries will be covered under Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Anna Yojana, which has been started from 1st of January 2023, under which the government will provide absolutely free of cost food grains to the beneficiaries of NFSA. Okay? So in rural areas it is 75%, in urban it is 50%. So option D is the correct answer to this question. All right guys, so that's it for today's class, and I hope all the questions and their explanations are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.